Hey guys, welcome back to another episode with Stoneheart and Banto, and oh my god, we got so many goblins invading us in this episode again, right from the beginning of the game. So we're gonna try to defeat this guy first. So I must say that I kind of feel like we really need to get one footman now, because a footman is gonna work a lot better than the people we got here. So I don't think it's gonna be a big problem if I would go for having at least one footman. It would make the place a little bit safer, and the footman deals more damage than our normal people do, so I think that's gonna help really much. So let's start with a wooden practice sword. Actually, we have one sword, so let's give that sword to one of our citizens. It's gonna be Lyanna Preston, so she's gonna be our footman. I'm gonna go arm my people again. So I think this is Lyanna who is gonna go and get that weapon. So now she's gonna be a footman, and she's gonna go around and like guard our city and keep people safe. So sometimes we might not really need to use our normal villagers, which have no like real work. Our builders, they are doing a lot of work, but they have no really like profession. So we have one working as a footman, so that's gonna be safer for our town. But we do not want to go for too many of those, because we want to make sure that we can always keep building stuff, so that's gonna be good. And it seems like the corn is gonna get ready soon. So this is gonna be nice. It's gonna be like the first corn we get. And this house is getting along nicely. It's getting built up, and I think that maybe we should try to make some things more advanced and start decorate some stuff soon to make buildings look better and look more like a home and more like a building for some profession. So I'm actually gonna try and see a thing, if a thing works that a guy told me about. Do this. Yeah, it actually seemed to work. Remove. So what I'm thinking about is like a guy that posted a comment on my video last time about making us like a storage house. So I'm really thinking about doing that, because you see, we can actually make storage here inside a building on top of that floor. I didn't think about that at all. I didn't think that you could actually use these things inside a house. I do not think you can make a farm. Maybe you can. That is strange if that's gonna work. Hopefully it's not gonna work. And if it does work, hopefully they're gonna change it. So if we want to make a storage house, I think that we want to make a pretty big barn. So it's going to be a little bit longer in one direction, and I don't know, maybe we should have it like behind other houses. So maybe thinking about having a barn here or something like that, or maybe a barn along this farm. I'm going to go for barn along those farms. So I'm going to start to design this directly, even though this house, it seems to be done actually. So we're gonna design a new house here, and we're gonna go for this floor. Gonna be pretty like a long one. A little bit longer, maybe that's too long. Hey, what's going on? Yeah, let's redo that. So let's put out it again. Something like that. And we want to have walls, and they're gonna be dark ones as well, pretty brownish one. And the roof for this. Let's go for an yellow roof. Just to make it maybe stand out a little bit. And we need to have a door, of course, so people can get in and get the stuff that they need to go and get. Let's go for one window there, and should have some windows at this as well. I think we're gonna go with just one window, maybe two here in the back, pretty close to each other. And one here, and another there. So that's gonna be pretty good. So that's gonna be our barn where we're gonna store resources. So in the future, I might actually store different resources at different places, just to make it look and feel more logical where we're gonna have it. So but inside here for the moment, we are actually gonna like put everything we find, and keep it inside it. I mean, we could have this barn for storing like only food. We can have it for storing resources such as wood and crafting materials. So we can have a stockpile that we're storing like furniture and such stuff. So, but for the moment, I think this is gonna be for almost everything for the moment. I think so, at least. We might make some smaller buildings for specific resources later on, but I think this is gonna be like for this for the moment, so I'm not gonna add the stockpile until they're getting closer to getting done inside this one. So I don't mess up anything. A bit risky sometimes to actually start doing things when they're not done with it. I have experienced some bugs with it before, so. Cut down some trees. We have still a lot of wooden logs here, or blocks. I don't know what they're called, oak log. So we have a lot of them still, so we're not really running out of them anyway, so. Seems to be going pretty good. And our footman is walking around making sure that our people are safe. That's awesome. But I think that we will just stay with one footman. Oh my god, okay, we got intruders. Get goblins, get them. Oh, she's got damage actually. Yeah, she had too many goblins on her at the same time, so for the moment, we're gonna use the footman and we're also gonna alert our people, because sometimes it comes those really big like invasions from the goblins, which make like one footman too few, so. And I do want to have my workforce working, so. Oh, the corn is growing on, that's good. And the pumpkins are starting to grow. Those were the one that grows really fast, but does not taste that good. So we have three different food resources for the moment, and probably gonna be a fourth with hunting animals soon. But I'm gonna try to have a lot of different food resources. What's this? A raccoon, small forest creature. A traveler approaches. A traveler approaches. You guys really look like you can use some help. Here's the traveler. I would like to leave you one farmer's hoe. Yeah, sure, do that. Why not? I actually think I missed one that came to us before, so. Yeah, they come from time to time. Sometimes you can actually get people that wants to join your village. So hopefully that's gonna happen in not too long time. Maybe we get an footman or something, so we do not have to put one of our current people as footman, because like I said before, I really want to have them building stuff. I want to have them chopping down trees, and it does seem like the farmers actually help with building their houses, though footmen are always busy patrolling around the city, but seems like the farmers actually helping with the building stuff, so. And the carpenter is actually also helping, so that's pretty good. This is gonna be pretty good. I'm really excited to see how this is gonna be, because I think this was a pretty good idea. I haven't thought about it at all, that you could use this, like I said before. I didn't think that you could use it at all. Place a stockpile for storm resources. For me it was like directly, since it's the farm, you can put it here. And since we could even put a farm inside a house, a bit strange. Not sure if it's gonna work. I might even try it later on just to see if it will work or not, just for the fun. And by the way, we built this house, so let's move some beds from this house into this house, because I do not want it to be way too crowded inside here. I want them to be more split up and like have their own houses. It's gonna be looking a lot more natural. So I think we're gonna have three beds in here, so we're gonna have one in this corner as well. I wouldn't want to sleep at all, like having those windows. One guy staring outside there, one guy staring outside there, watching you while you're sleeping. Maybe not the best positioning. Okay, now I took the bed. I'm wondering a bit why the beds got like this, where they are like tiny down there. Yeah, hopefully they're gonna move them later on. Gonna try this way, see if it helps anything. They are so busy building. And that's gonna make our house stand out a little bit more with having this yellowish roof, so for the moment, these three houses, as it looks, as for now at least, they're gonna be for people living inside here. I might change this house into some profession house, maybe have the carpenter or a tailor inside here. So a tailor is something we're gonna try to get pretty soon as well. So we're gonna be able to make all kinds of different carpets. We're gonna be able to make those hanging in on the windows. I don't know what they're actually called. We're gonna see when we get it. So they're starting to get pretty close to get done. And the pumpkins, wow, they are really growing fast. I mean, this corn has been growing for a really long time, but these pumpkins are going real fast. And even if it doesn't taste that good, we're at least gonna have enough food for our people to survive. It doesn't seem like we have much food lying around here. It seems to be running out all of the time. I don't know. Seems like this guy is actually sitting here, eating everything up. And maybe we should actually start to make some tables and chairs. Yeah, that's what we're gonna do. So our people are actually gonna have something, some place to sit and eat. So we're gonna make some dining tables. Let's craft two of these. Let's make three. And we can make like 8 chairs. And we're also gonna craft this weaver spindle so we can have a weaver later on. From fiber, thread, from thread, fabric, from fabric, civilization. And we can make these wooden dresses as well. Where they can put the clothes and writing, that's not at all like a raven, except it can produce a few notes, though they are very flat. But there are a lot of things to decorate and improve the comfort for our people inside here, so we can even make these comfy beds later on, which requires us to have one cloth resource. And for that we're gonna need a weaver's spindle. Actually gonna make two, let's make three wooden dresser. And we can make, let's make three of the writing desks as well. And let's make like three park benches. I'm gonna make some fence as well. Actually gonna make so we may always maintain 10 fences. And we're also gonna maintain always two fence gate. So it's gonna be a lot of wood resources for that, but I think it's gonna be fine. We have a tons of woods, you see? So many. So let's start chopping down some more. Actually, I have a lot of here, but let's get another one. Oh, what the hell? Oh no! Did I miss that we got invaded? They killed our footman. God damn it. One, two, three, four, five, six. God damn it. We lost one. I think this is the first time I actually lost one in this game. That's bad. So, hopefully we're gonna get a new guy or girl soon, because we do not want to get too little people here. We want to survive. I really wish that could make some babies happening in here. Go away, goblin. So let's get down the house again here and make a little stockpile. Maybe we can have it. Wait a moment. I think that we have, let's gonna check where we have the door. Okay, there we have the door. So we can actually make two sides if we wish to do so. So we can make like, either we can just fill the whole thing, or we can make like two sides like this. How many are there? Four. If we make like that, store everything, and we can make like this. Then we store things there and here, and people can actually walk between it, so I think that can be pretty good. But that's the problem with having a game. What are he doing? Go get him. Oh, they didn't get him. That's the problem with playing at high speeds. You want to get things done, but then instant your guy dies, so that's pretty bad. Pretty bad for us. You guys really look like you could use a hand. A footman would like to join. Awesome! The Fess Grail has joined Lomn. So that's perfect timing. Too bad he didn't come maybe a little bit earlier. Where do we have him? Where do we have this guy? Might be coming far away. Here we got her, Fess Grail. The footman. There are a lot of goblins invading us now, so maybe we should try to build some kind of defense against them. Maybe a fence or something would work against them, I'm not sure. Get him! Kill him! Oh, they're fleeing! Get a goblin! Yeah! You're never gonna go and kill people in Lomn ever again. Hopefully. But guys, this is going to be it for today with Stone Art, and I hope you liked this episode, and if you did, leave a thumbs up, it helps me really, really much. And if you'd like to see more with Stone Art and other game with me, Banto, go subscribe to my channel, and I'll see all of you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching, and have a great day. Take care.